Analysis Center and GDC 2.0 Workflow, Genomic Data Commons, GDC 2.0 Video Guides, Bill Wysocki, PhD, GDC User Services Lead, Center for Translational Data Science, University of Chicago. The cohort-centric GDC 2.0 workflow is designed for users to create a cohort or group of cases of interest and then analyze this cohort using the many tools available in the GDC Analysis Center. Files associated with cases that are in the cohort can be downloaded from the repository. Here we will demonstrate using this workflow and the features associated with the active cohort. The GDC 2.0 workflow. The first step in the GDC 2.0 workflow is to have what we call an active cohort, a saved cohort of cases that has been selected for analysis. The blue bar at the top of the portal is the cohort toolbar, which contains the name of the active cohort and the number of cases within it. Currently, the active cohort is a pre-built cohort named Lung 50 plus RNA. For directions on how to create a cohort, see the Cohort Builder tutorial video. The cohort toolbar is visible when using any tool, so that information about the active cohort can always be referenced while using the portal. Launching tools from the Analysis Center. The Analysis Center is where all the core features and analysis tools can be browsed and launched. The Analysis Center can be reached by first loading the GDC's data portal homepage at portal.gdc.cancer.gov, then clicking on Analysis Center, which is the computer screen icon in the upper left corner of the webpage. The tools in the Analysis Center are divided into core tools, which are related to building cohorts and viewing the projects, data, and files available in the GDC, and analysis tools, which perform various genomic and clinical data analyses. Each tool in the Analysis Center is represented with a card, which can be launched by choosing the Play button at the top right corner of each analysis tool card. A description of each tool can be viewed by choosing the down arrow at the right of the title. Note that the card arrangement and order may not be the same on all screens. Not all cases have the corresponding data analyzed by a given tool. Therefore, each analysis tool may analyze a different number of cases within the active cohort. Each analysis tool displays a number of cases under the title, which is the number of cases within the active cohort that have the corresponding data used by the tool. Here we see that the cohort comparison tool can analyze all 1,223 cases, while the mutation frequency tool can analyze 1,193 cases. Toolbar details. Below the cohort toolbar is the query toolbar, which displays the filters that were used to generate the active cohort. Filters can be collapsed or expanded by choosing the Collapse Expand button on the right. Here we see that values for tissue or organ of origin, experimental strategy, and age of diagnosis were used to generate this cohort. We can remove a filter by choosing the X at the right side of each filter. Single values for a specific property can be removed by clicking on them. To undo these changes and return to our original Lung 50 plus RNA cohort, we can choose the circular arrow next to the name of the cohort. Case summary view. To see additional case details and features, click on the number of cases in the cohort toolbar. This opens a summary view that displays five properties as cards: primary site, disease type, project, program, and gender. Each card is displayed as a bar graph, with each bar representing a property's value and the number of cases that reflect each value. Hovering over each bar will show a tooltip with the exact number of cases. The magnifying glass on the top right of a card allows users to filter down to a matching set of values or value. Here we will search for carcinoma and find one value matching this term. The middle page turn button at the top right of the card changes the card to the selection view. With this view, we can filter our cohort by specific values, which are added as additional filters in the query toolbar. Here we will choose disease type, adenomas, and adenocarcinomas. After filtering for values, we can save the resulting modified cohort by choosing the Save button, which overwrites the current cohort, or Save As button, which allows for a new, separate cohort to be created. We select Save As and create a new cohort named Lung 50 plus RNA adeno. In the gray area directly below the cohort toolbar are several additional buttons related to downloading files and filtering. The first button displays the number of files associated with the cohort. Clicking this button allows for us to Add all of the associated files to the cart. Download a manifest for these files. Download the metadata for these files. And download a sample sheet for these files. The second button from the left allows us to apply a custom filter based on a set of cases, genes, or mutations. For example, we can find all cases in this cohort with mutations in the TP53 gene. The new cohort with 915 cases can be saved as an additional cohort or discarded using the circular arrow button. The third and fourth buttons from the left allow us to download the clinical and biospecimen data for the cohort in JSON or TSV format. Table view. The button at the top right of the case detail panel allows us to toggle between the summary and table view. The table view contains a list of the cases in the active cohort, along with information about each, including project, primary site, and gender. Columns can be added or removed and arranged by choosing the triple line button at the top right of the table. We will add disease type to the table. The case ID column links to each case summary pop-up page, which contains further details about the case, plus clinical and biospecimen information. The project column links to a project summary pop-up page, which contains further details about the project and the available data. Each case can be selected using the checkbox in the leftmost column. A new cohort containing only the selected cases can be generated using the leftmost Save New Cohort button, with the Only Selected Cases option. The selected cases can also be added or removed from an existing cohort. To collapse the case detail page, click on the number of cases in the cohort toolbar. For information on specific tools, please refer to the other videos or go to docs.gdc.cancer.gov.